The following presentation was recorded at the NDS Public Conference in September 2020.
All right, so I'll be talking about the, so my name is Fabian Klebert. For the ones who don't know me, I think everyone in the room does. So I'll speak to the camera a little bit more than you guys. So everyone on camera is here and the other guys are there, so no worries. Yeah, I'll talk about the technical achievements of the last year, actually since the last General Assembly or NDS conference. And let's see if that works. So we're going to start with NDS Classic. Martin already said that. That is basically NDS.
Fabian, voice is low. I just get this feedback
voice
here.
Is low.
Audio is low. Very low volume of speaker. Fabian is really hard to hear, so it's all variances of the same.
Okay, got it. So... is it, so maybe I have to, let's see, is it better now?
So,
is that better now? I mean, hopefully you can hear that, so.
Could you, the guys, guys, could you people. Just type in the Q&A again whether it's better now?
Is it? So, I hope, you should also hear it via this, I mean, you hear it as well, right?
Yes.
So, okay.
I heard it before.
Okay,
but
okay, I tried to speak up a little if necessary. So, NDS Classic is like the NDS as we know it in the latest version, official version 2.5.4. We have added, there are these fast track extensions that we have in NDS, and we have added in the last year two new ones. First one is the location fast track extension, which supports stable identifiers. So main use cases for this is to map SD and HD maps from, for instance, different vendors, as well as integrating dynamic services along. And we have another one where this headline that says in focus function safety already comes in place. We added the signature fast track extension, which actually enables us to have end-to-end data integrity protection by signing each and every data blob that goes over the wire, if so, and that prevents basically manipulation of the HD data. And then we had an ASIL task force mainly working on the requirements for an ASIL-ready C++ code generator. And I have that on the next slide. That we have also now a for NDS members only, actually, a Xero ASIL ready C++ code generator generated. So this comes with, so it's not certified, it's ASIL ready. So in terms of, we got the requirements from the OEMs, what they would need to include that in an ASIL system. And Andre.
A little bit louder. I get mixed feedback. Some of them say it's okay now, but the other half says it's still not loud enough.
Okay. Yeah. So let's see if this, I don't know if this gets better without too many. Aber setzt du doch nur einfach dein Ding so. Okay. So, komplett, setz mal komplett auf. So anyhow, so I'm trying to maybe not speak up too much or so, but hopefully it doesn't go away. So anyways, as you also see, we have for the ASIL ready C++ code generator, we also offer round trip validation so that you can basically deserialize and serialize. And therefore we, and in addition to that, and I hope now the voice is better, or yeah, is that good now? Okay. So in SQLite, we also did, we did some changes to significantly reduce the memory consumption for NDS databases that are already in the field. So by just simply upgrading to that latest SQLite engine, you could significantly reduce the memory consumption of your app. And we have updated the JDBC drivers for this. Mainly JDBC drivers being used in the compilers. When, in addition to the NDS Classic tools that, I mean, Martin already said that, we have also enhanced the database inspector and map viewer. So basically, mainly we improved the lane visualization and attribute search functionalities. Rendering performance was a big issue still last year, but we have significantly increased that. We added a lot of smaller community features, so especially hearing to the NDS community, listening to the developers that use it day in, day out, and embedded or implemented smaller features that they find helpful. And what was also new, I mean, we did have a MapViewer extension already for C++. Now there's one for Python as well, since Python seems to be more and more also in the automotive world, more and more the go-to language of programming stuff. So we thought we have to support that as well. For the OpenDrive converter, which basically converts OpenDrive to NDS and NDS to OpenDrive, we upgraded the NDS OpenDrive converter to support the latest version, which is 2018 released NDS 2.5.4. So this was basically already done in 2019 after the last General Assembly. So it's there for quite a while already. And we had made smaller adaptions that the converter works with all the various OpenDrive editors. Because if you are from the OpenDrive community, you know that there are certain, I would say, dialects or flavors around, and they behave all a little different. And we have adapted it so that a wider community can actually use it and to make it more usable. On the technical organization, we have also improved our processes. We have established a development process for NDS Live. So this development process is actually it comes along with the fact that NDS Live is modular. We'll learn about something like this later on. And we're looking for a continuous delivery process, more agile, and also aligned with the NDS roadmap. So all the modules, they get versioned independently, they get released independently, and all of that. And therefore, we needed somehow first aligned process to do that. We have also a workflow established from the product definition group that has been set up in NDS over the last, which is actually active already for a year or two. But we still had to really nail down a process that their results really end up in the development of the NDS standard. So there is really alignment between the PDG, which is the NDS product management group, and the NDS technical committee and the working groups. So this is basically what you see here in the small screens. This is one of the processes there, the small picture. All right, so for NDS Live, here's only a teaser for later on. So NDS Live is not a database, it's a distributed map system. So we'll learn about this later on. So that's why I wrote down details later. We have a dedicated slot in, I think, roughly an hour or two, it's a bit more like 2 hours. And why I bring it up here again is because it actually makes up most of the work of the working groups at the moment. And that wasn't reflected in my slides here. So I thought I'll bring it up here already. Stay tuned and we'll show what's going on later. Okay, so, but all around NDS Live, there's also been some other news that we have. So we introduced the NDS Islands recently during the last year. NDS Islands is basically sample maps for NDS. At the moment, they focus on NDS Live. They're with the goal to boost the development, to improve interoperability. And they are artificially created in a map editor. So we don't have any problems with source data licensing or anything like that. Every NDS member can use it because it's simply artificial data, some islands that we put there. And we're utilizing the NDS infrastructure and NDS Live reference implementation to really deploy them as a service. So in NDS Live, also a preview on later on, it's really about services. And these sample maps, they will already be served live on NDS servers to all of the members. So you can simply access it every time, everywhere. And I think that's a big plus. So also for NDS Live, we had to bring up a lot more tools and tooling. I already told you that it is modular. It is versioned independently. But what I didn't say yet is there's simply still small dependencies. And there's some things that are not compatible with each other. And to really make this work, we came up with the implementation of a package manager that does all that. So to all the module versions you see here, you see on the screen, it's a web interface and also a REST API. So you can actually, you don't have to go via the web interface always. You can embed this into your CI workflows and use it via the REST API as well. It generates code for you. It generates documentation for you based on the set of modules that you want, right? It checks whether they are compatible. It resolves the dependencies for this, all that stuff a modern package manager does. And in addition to that, we have also released the so-called NDS Live tools, which are developer packages for Python. So at the moment, we're focusing on Python because in a survey among the NDS Live developer community, that was the go-to language for everyone. So we said, okay, let's focus on that one. Which is basically a module you can simply pip install in your Python environment, and then you're getting all the released NDS modules. You're getting access to the map viewer, to a map viewer API. It's really developer tools. You can start hacking with NDS in Python with that, with a one-click installation, more or less. So this is also something we never had in NDS, and this should really improve the developer experience of an NDS development. In addition to that, or basically based on that, we have released already LifeLab in its early version. So we'll do another release by end of the month. And so that's an app and web-based IDE, more or less, for all the live tools. So that I just talked about. So there you have them together in IDE. You have the map viewer with a one-click thing. So you can use it as an app. You can deploy it on a server for your whole team, or whatever fits best, right? And it has this user interface that you can really inspect the map data and the service interfaces and connect to services and so on and so forth. And this is also a major thing we worked on. Plus, we also implemented a couple of reference implementations to enable NDS Live developers to really get going and getting started and not having to do the basics from ground up, but to really focus on their content delivery and not like the service infrastructure to set this up and so on and so forth. So this is why we have reference implementations available for the registry server and client and for the smart layer server and client. And we will see how this got utilized later on today. And I'm really looking forward to this, so stay tuned. And this is actually the achievement slides. And if you have any questions, let me know.
Thank you for watching. Visit our website for news on NDS at nds-association.org.